Well, looky there. We're live, and guess who's with me? Mr. Jason the Love Brown. And we're, look at that. That's 2 weeks in a row. I'm going to have to start painting. I'm excited to be here tonight. This is episode number 162, Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. And you can catch all these episodes if you've missed any. And if it makes you feel any better, there's only about 400 episodes before we started counting again. So we're at 160. We're at 162. But you don't need to. The nice part is you can ask us anything in the comments down below, and we'll be happy to answer them the best we know how. Now, if you ask us about brain surgery or something, or rocket surgery, probably not going to get much luck. So here's the deal. We've got questions in here that people have already submitted. Heather makes me a list every week. Jason's going to help me answer these questions. And if you have any questions during this, feel free to pop them up. I got in trouble by somebody. Somebody called me out on YouTube because these broadcasts go over to YouTube. Somebody called me out and said, "You waste a lot of time calling out and recognizing people on the show," which made me just want to recognize more people. So, by the way, James Jones is in the house right there. Jose Pinto, my man. Jose Pinto, like, started with nothing, crock pot and a grill, and made 500 the first weekend on a Sunday. Second Sunday makes over, what was it, 1,500, 1,000, something like that. And then third weekend, three grand. You know why? You know why? He got my course. You want the course? LearnHotDogs.com. This is cheap, 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 cheap. LearnHotDogs.com/now. Now. /now. I think it's less than $6, $10, less than $5, I think. And we have other vendors on here. You'll probably see them tonight. Cheryl, if she gets on here, started with crock pots. 3 weeks later, she's got a cart. Okay. Now, Lisa Jones, Jim and Lisa are in from Jamba. I hope I pronounced that right. Jamba Dogs are here and ready to learn. Thanks for being here, Lisa. The Great American Hot Dog Stand in the house. Look there, Mark Lawler, trying to show off. Thanks for being here, Mark. Heather's in the house. If y'all wonder how everything stays running smoothly, Heather. Michael's here with Doug's Dogs. Been around for, I don't know, since Noah landed the Ark.
Since Chris, the corporal in the Army.
Yeah. So we got Owen Lewis. I'm going to run through these real quick so we can get started. John Russell, Jason Oliva, Anthony, Tony Garcia, Charles Newman. Hey, everybody. Greg Bruce is in the house. Just bought my first cart 20 minutes ago. I found a big dog cart for $17.50. Go, Greg. Kick butt. Kenny Allison. Sup, Ben and Jason. Michael Wood. Again, Heather. Jose Pinto. Babs O'Hare. Oh, look. Look. Babs O'Hare in the house. Thanks for being here, Babs. Billy Blair. She's in the Vendors United group. Heather. I don't know about running smoothly. Well, we do our best, Heather, right? Right? I make mistakes. You fix my mistakes. So, it works out pretty good. Happy Hot Dog Company and Catering, soon to be Roaming Nomad Dogs. PETA not approved. I like that. Look at Babs O'Hare says PETA not approved. Babs is fixing to get her a pig roaster pro from Roasting Nomad. She's going to join the tribe, Jason. What do you think? Yeah. Troy's here. Tony's here. Thanks for being here, y'all. I'm going to get started. Don't think I'm ignoring you. I'm excited that you're here and I appreciate it. Here's the deal. Vendor of the week. This is what happens when you put me in charge of vendor of the week. Okay. This would be funny. You ready? Hold on. I actually have an answer for this question, but you're going to have to bear with me. Okay. Heather's probably her skin's probably just melting off of her right now. And we had a major meltdown at learnhotdogs.com. And the site went down. It's been down for over 24 hours. She's worked around the clock with a team to try to get that back running. Your picture, Jason, keeps going bright to dark, to bright to dark. Yeah, it looks good when it's bright. I'm telling you, that looks sharp. But anyway, she's been working on stuff. She goes, "Hey, do you mind picking the vendor of the week this week?" And I said, "No problem." 5 minutes before the show, I said, hadn't picked the vendor of the week. So here, I'm going to call one. Okay. I hope they're here. They don't have a Facebook page. They do not have a Facebook page. No. Rocket Dogs. Rock, R-O-C, then I-T, then Dogs. Rocket Dogs is in, I don't know if they're in the house, but they just started vending. Their first day, I posted up in their words on this page, somewhere down below us, what they posted, I think yesterday. I think they did like $110 first day, trial run, kicked butt. You ought to read what they wrote. It makes me happy. Makes me happy to be a part of such awesome freaking people. So question, you ready for a question, Jason? Ready to get stumped?
Yep, go ahead.
All right. How do I pay taxes in New Jersey for my card? I can't find info anywhere, and people are saying I need a vendor's license. Is this true? I'm already selling dogs, though. Help, please.
Well, that's an easy one. You want to get to your State Department of Banking, get yourself a retail license.
Or just look up, watch this. This is how easy this is. Jason, you keep going. She had two questions, and I'm going to look up something.
Wait, what was the other question? I heard taxes.
And she's been vending without a license.
Oh, boy. All right. So you're going to need to call your health department and get yourself a license. You might have to go through plan review. Then they'll give you a mobile vendor's license, I believe is what New Jersey still does. But you definitely want to try and get legal. I mean, hopefully you don't get caught between now and then.
Either way, it's probably going to be a slap on the wrist. But Jason's right. You want to do things the right way. You want to do your due diligence. But thanks for the question. Here's your first link. Look at this. One little Google search away. And I'm also going to put this in the comments so that you can link directly to it. That's the link to your New Jersey to get your sales tax thing. I believe they do it online and instantly. So you'll have a sales tax number. Now you can buy stuff without paying for tax, paying yep. tax on it.
Yeah, and now when you go to Costco and things, you can get that little R for BJ's and Costco for resale, and then you'll get charged tax.
There you go. The other thing you need to do is call your local health department.
Yep.
And you'll need to find your here. Here's what you'll punch into Google. Your county, and then put health department, and then phone number. Call that number and go, "Hey, health department, I need to know who does the restaurants inspections in my town." And they'll go, "Oh, that's Bob. He does them all over." Or, "Oh, which part of town?" "Oh, well, that's Susan. Susan does it over in the east side of your town." Well, can I get her number? Sure. Here's her number. I'll connect you. And they connect you and you go, "Hey, Susan, I'm thinking about opening a hot dog cart or a catering business." I'd say catering. Say catering. And if you don't believe me, watch our shows and you'll see why. Go to learnhotdogs.com, free training, and go through that. You'll do it the right way. So that's that. You ready for the next one? Thanks for the question, Arby. I appreciate Aubrey.
Aubrey.
Sorry, I said Arby. It's
probably Aubrey.
Aubrey.
Aubrey James.
It's A-B-R-Y.
Probably Aubrey.
Aubrey? Cool. Question from Josh. "Hey, I'm going to try the big Texas cinnamon rolls tomorrow. I've done them a lot. I love them. It probably accounted for 30 pounds on me. But what should I put them in? I didn't think people seeing me unwrap them and all that. Going to grill them on a small griddle like Chris, smother them in homemade cream cheese icing." No, I wouldn't do all that. You're on a cart. I wouldn't do it. You could do that on catering gigs. I would have those suckers hanging from a chip clip let them get hot and moist in that bag on the chip clip.
It's going to make a mess of your grill, man, if you do it that way.
Do what?
It's going to make a mess of the grill if you do.
Oh, the sugars will make a mess of the grill.
Not to mention then the leftover sugar is going to burn, which is going to off-flavor the next one. No, thanks.
And it's got, not only that, then you go to put onions and peppers on the grill, or you put hot dogs or sausages on the grill. You're going to have sugar-coated, burnt sugar-coated stuff. Don't, Josh, here's what I'd tell you. I'm not saying you're wrong. I'm saying I'm a hillbilly and I've tried about everything. I would not waste my time with that. If they wanted it heated up, I'd put a couple, if you find that heated up ones work good, put a couple in your steam table.
Yep.
And they'll heat up inside the bag. Doesn't matter that they know where you got them. They know where you got your Coke can.
Yep.
You're there for convenience and a good meal. That side item isn't supposed to be homemade. Okay. Don't make more of this than you should. And you'll find that you'll wear yourself out quick. Provide a good lunch. Let the side items be something side. If it's in a bag or it says Pringles or Doritos on the bag, doesn't matter. You don't need to make it your own bag. You agree, Jason?
Oh, yeah. Yep, definitely.
Question from Daniel B. What brand of hot dog is used by most vendors? This is no joke. I don't mind the question, Daniel, so don't get mad. Okay? But I bet this question comes up at least every three shows.
Yeah.
And I answer it every time. It's all over the blog. It's one of the most asked questions. It's not the most asked question, but I think it's number two or number three in the top 10 list. Answer that for him. What would you do, Jason?
It's regional. You know, we've got guys up north that use those all red dogs with the natural casing. You know, New York, I'd say probably Sabrette. You know, Snapdog's making a pretty good push up there. It's different everywhere.
What would you do to test it, though?
I would test what you got locally. You know, I'd see what's in the stores locally, check a couple stores and ask the deli manager what sells the most, and then check with your local broadline and ask them what they're stocking and what they sell the most of.
When Jason says broadline, he's talking about Sysco, any of your food delivery companies, IJ Foods, US Foods. Here's something you can do as well. Go to the grocery store. Don't have to talk to anybody. Walk to the hot dog shelf. See what they stock the most of. Probably the most popular brand. Probably. Okay. Now, does that mean that is what you need to serve? No. You need to do a taste test. Have some friends and family over and do a taste test. And cut the dogs up, put colored toothpicks in each one. Ask them, please, to refrain from condiments or do minimal condiments at first so that they can take a bite of the blue toothpick one, the red toothpick one, the orange toothpick one, the green toothpick one, and go, oh, I like the green. So you get 11 green ones and two blue ones that one, you know, to go with the green dog. It's a blind taste test.
I'll tell you what, Snapdog is, they got a good dog. He sent me some samples and one of the comments just popped up and, it's a good dog. The other one I like, as you know, is still the National Deli 6-1. They're a great skinless dog.
Yeah, Crazy Dogs is selling Snapdogs, right?
Yeah. They still got to get their stuff together with distribution and shipping.
Yeah, it's a little expensive.
Yeah, but it's getting there. You know, once he gets that squared away nationwide, I think he's going to be a force to be reckoned with.
That good?
Yeah. I would say rivals Vienna.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Well.
The steam, now, as you know, I don't boil. I steam my dogs.
Now, Daniel, I boil.
Yep.
But then I put in steamer as a holder, but only temporary. I don't hold dogs for 2 hours. If I'm holding dogs for 2 hours, I need a new location.
Yeah.
I will tell you that I will give you a name of a dog that is my favorite dog, but they also are regional and they're nowhere near me, but I was told by a listener on this show And I tried them, and I get a lot of hot dogs sent to me. I'm telling you, I get at least something sent to me every week to try. And there's one hot dog that I like a lot. It's called a Zweigles. It's Z-W-I-E-G-L-E-S. And it's from up north.
That's a New England dog.
It is. I have never tasted a better hot dog in my life. And I'd put it up against. But, you know, opinions, taste buds, and buttholes. Everybody's got them. And they're all different. So I don't know that I would take my word for it or Jason's word for it. What I do is do a taste test. It is smart, though, to try a brand from out of town, kind of like Crazy Dogs did. They were smart. They brought Crazy Dogs to Tennessee.
And he did well with the branding. He gave him umbrellas and a lot of stuff. He's doing pretty well with the swag.
Yeah, but I mean, he's gotten all kinds of news stories on him and everything because he picked Snap Dogs and did it. I happened to be with Jason when he got his Snap Dogs, but Jason Stingy didn't get. He only got three cases, so he didn't give me one, even a bite. All right.
I would say some of the people are asking. I would say call Keith, let him know you heard from Ben and Jason. Give him a call. We'll get you some samples. And we are trying to work a deal there. But the biggest holdup right now is distribution. There's no sense finishing the deal yet if I can't get you the dogs. So, you know.
Not other than shipping them overnight freight through FedEx and you pay nine times what they're worth.
Yeah.
And that's the problem with Zweigels, too, is it's a – It is a delicious dog, but man, is it expensive to have it shipped. That's where the expense comes in.
Well, they get you because you got dry ice in there. So you got the expense of dry ice. Then you got the cost of shipping with dry ice, which jacks it way up because it's considered hazardous.
Right. So Daniel, great question. Thanks for asking. Jim of Jamba Dogs. Do you think we should track waste, i.e. hot dogs and buns that have been thrown away, wondering if we can write it off?
Always shrinkage. Always.
You can write everything. You can write off napkins that blow off your cart.
Yep.
And you don't have to count them. Okay. But I've been in a situation. I was in Florida actually. And I'm talking all kinds of stuff got damaged from a pop-up thunderstorm. And I figured I lost about $400 and just in paper products and stuff. And that's write offable because it was a real loss.
What you did was create a Excel sheet or some type of sheet that you fill out every day. If you throw away $5, $10, you got to track that because at the end of the month, that can be quite a bit of stuff.
But also quit throwing away dogs. Let me tell you what you do. Dogs are like going to the newspaper and buying a $35 ad. You know, a display ad in the classified section. Give those dogs away. Go to the homeless shelter. If you don't have a homeless shelter, go by the police station, sheriff's department. Jason, a lot of times, will pull up at the state police. He's got a state police near him and their main headquarters. He pulls up and goes, boop, here's some food. Well, goes a long ways. Who do you think they're going to call when they want catering or when they think hot dogs or, hey, babe, we're going into town tonight. I wonder if Love Food Truck's going to be in town. I try to give all my food away. I try not to throw away nothing.
Well, or use it as a cookie drop. You can still write it off. I mean, you know.
Oh, yeah, you can still write it off. But I'd rather be helping somebody than throw it in the trash.
But use it, you know, and give food to your mechanics, Jen says. Yep. Jenny just signed in. You know, that's something too. You can do your cookie drop then. You know, you wanted to stop by and get that office complex, run them into the gatekeeper up front, you know, get them to her. So say, hey, I'm going to drop off a catering menu. Here's a couple dogs or here's this or here's that.
Right.
Never know what it's going to do, man.
James R., do I have to register and insure the cart as a trailer vehicle since it will be on the road?
Depends where you're at. Some places don't even require a tag for that small of a trailer. Here in Pennsylvania, we have to tag everything. So, you know, again, I don't know where he's at. Does it say?
Yeah, it doesn't say, but Tennessee, you don't have to tag nothing. If it's a trailer, you don't have to tag it in Tennessee unless the trailer is larger than the vehicle towing it.
Yeah.
So, you don't, I mean, you could have a 25 foot trailer in Tennessee with no tag, no title, no nothing. Now you go to like North Carolina or Florida, Georgia, you got to have a tag. As far as registering it, that is registering it to get a tag and insuring it. Some states require you insure peripheral towed vehicles. Some don't. You'll have to ask, but you ask that at the tag office. You can call them and ask them. Probably can Google it and ask them.
Robbie, that's the other side of the state. I'm over by the Eagles, buddy. Steelers on the other side.
From Doom Lead, can you do a video on retrofitting a cart to add things like sinks or a griddle? I'm moving to another state that requires four sinks instead of one. I'm also thinking of adding a griddle to my cart. Let me tell you the best way to do this. I'll do a short answer. Go to buildacart.com. Okay. And you're probably going, oh, he's selling me something. I am. It's about $100. It may be 40, but I don't remember what it is. It's less than $100. You can get a whole course on building a cart. Do you need it all? No. But if you're retrofitting, it'll teach you everything you need to know to retrofit, what to use, how to do it, and without having to buy a bunch of crap. It'll show you how to turn a pan into a sink, how to take a hole and make two sinks out of it instead of one. Everything's in there. And yes, you can do it. Absolutely, you can do it. Next question from Mega Metal Merchant. Hi, Ben. Killer videos. Thanks so much for sharing your knowledge with us. I would like to ask you, I plan on just renting my cart out. Do I still need to get permits? Any help from anybody is greatly appreciated. I live in Houston, Texas. Cheers.
Well, it depends what you're renting it out for. Are you renting it out for a street vendor, or are we renting it out for catering?
Right.
Or are you renting it out as a mobile kitchen for, you know, a homeowner to use for a party?
Then you don't have the license.
Yeah. So, I mean, couple different ways. The other thing, are we renting it to Ben, who's going to use it every day, or is it a one-time thing Ben's using to try something, you know?
Or Ben's using it to go street food vend one time.
Yep.
Well, if it's not licensed, then Ben's going to have to get a license,
yep.
Which is going to take longer than a day. In Houston, it will for sure.
Idea.
But here's the deal. I'm going to help you out a ton. I'm going to give you more information than you probably want, and I'm going to give it to you real short in one link, and hopefully Heather can post this up for me. Learnhotdogs.com/expand. It is a master class that I'm going to be selling for about $100, and right now you can watch it for free. So watch it for free. You'll find out how I went to 22 carts back down to 6 and how I made my 6 make more than the 22. And what avenues to use and what you need to know about renting a cart and licensing a cart. And can you rent a cart without a license? Absolutely you can. Jason just brought it up to you. Catering. People are having a family reunion, want an outdoor kitchen. They're going to the state park. They normally take a portable grill. Now they can take your cart. Do you need a license for that? Nope. It's not being served to the public. It's private use only.
Well, and the course isn't really free, even though it's free right now. We're just charging Michael and Doug's dogs. He just doesn't know it. So
yeah, he's got a huge bill.
Yes, don't tell him.
Yeah, Michael has a huge bill.
Yeah, that's so much.
I'm going to have to break his bill up into monthlies.
He's going to have to work 8 days a month now rather than 7.
Yeah, that's it. Last one. Yeah.
Somebody asked about cans or bottles. It all depends what stacks in your cart. On my truck, I prefer cans. We do sell the glass bottles, but cans stack easier. They transport easier to ice, and they don't break the way glass does. But that's just me. So it flashed across. I didn't see who that was.
I can go through these and pull them up. We got one more, and then I'll answer the one on the screen.
All right, got you.
From Pancakes. I've been a computer programmer who has created games since the age of 11, but the idea of working for someone else my entire life sends me into a panic attack anytime I think of it. I feel I will have a better chance at determining my own future as a hot dog vendor, will the money I receive be a reflection of how hard I work, like I hope? It depends on your definition of reflection. I do not want to sell you pie in the sky. This is still work. You can't stay at home and play Xbox or watch Oprah Winfrey reruns. You're going to have to work it. I've got thousands of vendors on this page that will tell you it's work, but it's good pay for the work. Once you nail down your locations and you got a system going, and this doesn't have to take years or anything. It's usually, you know, within a couple, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, you've got it down, especially if you've done your due diligence prior. Do you have to buy anything? Do what?
Jose just said that. Due diligence gets results. It's true.
Yeah. Jose's made roughly $4,500 three weekends in a row, working only Sundays because his full-time job is 60 to 70 hours a week. And he gets paid about $600 a week. He doesn't mind me saying that. He actually made a video and posted it here on this page. Yep. So I'm not like sharing something I didn't have permission to share. Jose is a hard worker. He took his day off, his only day off a week, when he gets one, and he used it with a crock pot and a grill on a table, and now he's making lemonade with it at a flea market, and he's kicking butt. Can you do that? Absolutely. Can you make money with a cart? Absolutely. And now it's better than what I'd have taught you 3 years ago. Still would have made you money, but now we've learned more stuff, more better ways to do it. And so it's foolproof to me. Okay. I know that if a vendor goes through my free training, doesn't buy nothing, goes through my free training, and applies that information, they will be successful. Not might be, not, oh, it's luck of the draw. It's dig a hole type stuff. Everybody can dig a hole, period. You can dig a hole. You could use the wrong end of the shovel and still get a hole. What Jason and I teach is how to use the right end of the shovel and how to find how to find the softest dirt. But if you follow the steps, you're going to get a hole every time. You will be successful in vending every time. Is it work? Yes. Is it sometimes you don't want to do it? Yes. But what isn't?
Yeah, but it's a lot nicer being your own boss. And, you know, like you're seeing Mac Ladfelder now, he's got a year under his belt. You're seeing him take a day off and go with the kids to the zoo. He's now getting second and third carts, and he's bringing people to work, which is going to mean more freedom at home for him and the family. So, you know, it is doable. You guys see it on Vendors United. You see all the vendors on there, new people. I mean, look at all these guys that are starting, you know, don't even have a cart or a trailer yet. They're waiting for product to be delivered, and they're out selling bread at one of the flea markets to make money until they get it done. And, you know, somebody else was roadside and, you know, selling snacks and things. So, you know, it's doable. It's just how bad you want to change from computer programming to something else. Is it work? Yeah, sure. It's work, but I'll take working over myself than anything. I don't want to work for anybody ever again.
No. And can Jason today, can you today, Jason, go, you know what? I'm going to Florida for the next week. Now, you may not want to, but what I'm saying is, can you?
Yeah, Jenny might kill me if I, you know, took off and went to Florida real quick. But, you know, as long as she had help and.
Right. But my point is you have the ability to, where at a JLB you can't.
No, she can run anything I've got. She can drive any truck. She can drive truck and trailers. She can handle the commissary. She can handle customers. You know, we got a new landscaping company running in our commissary, like over on the side. She came in one day, and those guys had our hose stretched out cleaning trucks, boy. And I'll tell you what, you've seen her. She's small, but boy, she went over there and lit some ass. You know, she told those guys, don't be grabbing our water hose to clean off dump trucks and stuff. And next time she came in and they're messing with the hose, boy, they shut it down and ran it back and apologized. So, you know, but she can handle anything. I can leave tomorrow. I can go back down with Ben and, you know, I don't have a worry in the world between her and, you know, Ian and Jeff. And I wouldn't second guess any decision she makes, because when I'm not there, I've got complete confidence in her for making decisions, whether it's closing early, product, menu, whatever it is.
Right. Can you take the question on the screen?
Got a big dog cart, no grill or griddle. What's the most product variety you would offer? Right now, we're just doing plain dogs, coney dogs. Should we offer more? Well, I mean, you could offer lemonade, you know?
Yeah, but what can he do from the steam tables on a grill, Jason?
Oh my God, without a grill, anything. I mean, you know, you get a little smoker at home, or you can do some braised beef and do tacos off it. You can do barbecue off it. I mean, you
pasta.
A steam table. I mean, you can do chili in the winter. You can do soups.
We got vendors that only do soup.
Yeah.
We got vendors that do baked potatoes off the big dog cart.
I was going to say, baked potatoes, keep them in a cooler. You can do Mexican street corn, have it a ton in the cooler, pull it out and dress it real quick, and off it goes on a stick. I mean,
Your question.
A lot of things. You don't have to have the grill to do this. You could pre-cook sausage at the commissary and take it with you on the steam table. So you could be doing hot Italians. You could do a little bit of exotic sausage. You could do anything. It's just, you could do burgers. Just got to heat them up, you know, cook them. Bring them on a steam table, and they're not going to be able to melt the cheese since you're on the grill. But
put them in that au jus sauce, you know.
Oh, yeah. That's how we keep them.
You float the burgers in au jus. I think Matt's done it before. I've done it before. I learned that from Keith, my partner. He showed me how to, you know, float burgers in au jus, and then you pull them out and serve them. Now you got a good burger, a good, soft, flavorful burger. But
a lot of things you could do, James.
Yeah, he says, should we offer more? Well, that depends on how you're doing. If you need to offer more, I would. But, James, honestly, I've been beaten. I feel like I've been beating a dead horse. Not you, James. But for 3.5 years, Jason and I have pushed the hell out of vendors going into catering.
Yep.
And there is no limit to what you can serve from that big dog cart. You have a commercial kitchen. You have a restaurant on wheels, a mobile kitchen right there in your hands that will make you a fortune as a caterer. And I'm not talking a caterer that pulls up and puts fine linens out and, you know, fluffy chairs. I'm talking just catering spaghetti dinners, catering a soup menu. If you're not a part of Vendors United, Heather may post up the link for me, but you can go to learnhotdogs.com/join and just watch the video and see if you want in. There's no commitment. It's not like a contract.
James, if he doesn't want to get into more food, he can do, you know, mac and cheese, beef stew as it gets colder, chili.
Right.
You know, I mean, the mac and cheese would be a great side. It can also be in addition to the dogs with some other toppings. I don't know if you saw a launch pad today. Dave did, I think it was mac and cheese with crab on top and maybe some Old Bay seasoning. There's a ton of stuff you can do. I mean, you know, take a look at Vendors United if you're not there yet, James. And, you know, you can talk to vendors there and ask questions. But even without the grill, ton of stuff you can do, man. Don't sweat it.
Other questions. Cheryl says she's getting in the shower before the power goes out. Got some weather going on.
Is she taking us in there?
Yeah. Are you taking us with you? You're going to listen to the show in the shower. Robbie says, lay on the cart, steam right up. I don't know what he's
talking back about the steam, the cinnamon buns. That's what
that is. Snapdog should try to get a deal with Vendors United. Lisa, we are trying. Haven't got a deal yet. I know they are getting overwhelmed with calls. They're getting calls because of the show, because Robbie Miller told in Crazy Dogs, Tammy and Robbie, they told us about it and started pushing it. And then they went crazy in Tennessee here with it. And then Jason got some, and now other people are getting them. I think, who was it? It's getting them in Michigan.
Bigfoot?
No. She's in here. I don't know where it is right now, but, it may be the person I have on. Yeah. Lisa's trying. Yeah. Lisa mentioned getting them in Michigan.
Yeah. They sent her a couple cases.
Let's see. Tony says they haven't followed up with him yet. I understand they're having growing pains.
He was just at a restaurant show. I mean, it's one guy running this thing, and he's doing a decent job, Tony. But give him a call. Tony, talk to Ben and I, and, you know.
Yeah.
Keith, you know, get on the ball, dude.
Nathan's natural casing is not a bad second choice for Snapdog. I agree. I'd also recommend the Zweigels. Now, I'm not affiliated with them. They don't even know I'm talking about them. I'm just telling you it's the best hot dog I've ever put in my mouth. But I have not tried a Snapdog yet. Okay? I haven't tried it.
I'll bring some down. When I come down in a couple weeks, I'll bring some. Babs, no, I didn't order any of the onion sauce. He sent me three cases, and it was supposed to be three different products, and I wound up with three of the same.
Jason did too.
Yeah.
Jason had the same deal. They were supposed to send three different products. They sent three cases of the same thing.
Yep.
They're just having a little bit of an issue.
He's got a fulfillment center, and you know that's always an issue when you're handing your stuff over to a fulfillment center and then you know trying to get the right product pulled and, you know, yeah.
Howdy to Kingdom Concessions. Glad you're here. Thanks for being here. Jennifer says, give food to your mechanics. Absolutely. I've given them to the tire shop, whoever is near me. Hey.
What she's saying is, you know, I stop by and I feed my mechanic because if I'm in a jam, Jenny and I were going somewhere over the winter and the heater started smoking, man, I made a detour. We pulled in there. You couldn't have shoved any more guys up in the front of my truck. And, you know, 10 minutes, I'm back on the road, you know. So that's why I stop, feed my mechanics probably 3-4 times a month. It's four guys in the shop. We were there today. I brought in lemonades. I did three flavors of lemonades. Jenny threw duck jalapeno with bacon sausage. I think some buffalo chicken and some Italian, maybe some chili cheese dogs. But, again, this, you know, it's a cookie drop. Look at it as a cookie drop.
And y'all, I don't know if Heather put the link up here, but if you go to learnhotdogs.com/join, Michael Wood is a huge contributor there. You're talking about a pro vendor who gives us a for somebody from Georgia, he's pretty dang smart. He's got some awesome Excel spreadsheets. I give him a hard time, so no offense to anybody else in Georgia. I got family in Georgia.
Well, I think he's wise enough because he said he still hasn't gotten his check, so I think he is catching on to why that video is free because we keep subtracting it off his check.
Yeah, yeah. But he's got uniforms, mileage, waste, and all kinds of stuff to track if you want to track easily and keep up with your numbers. Michael Wood can tell you to the day how much he's improved over last month, last year, the 2nd of November, 3 years ago, or 8 years ago. He knows exactly what he did when. And he was vending part-time 3 days, 4 days a month for years till this year, and now he's swamped. He went from part-time to, he went to almost part-time to part-time now. Yeah. He's doing like 6-7 days a week now.
I mean, that's a lot for Michael.
Yeah. We don't want to work him too hard. He's old. I think he's 92 or something. I'm not sure. His wife is like 35, but he's like in his 80s or 90s.
He's got a lot of Donald Duck statues and toys to dust and rearrange on shelves now he's retired.
That's right. Let's see. Look, Jose Pino. This is Chef Jose. Y'all need to look up his videos at learnhotdogs.com or right here. Just punch in the search here on Facebook, Chef Jose or Chef, and you'll see his videos that he's posted. Unbelievable. He says, giving hot dog gets you a tax write-off and promotes your business. Absolutely. Way better than putting it in the trash. Anything else? Oh, money grab. We forgot the money grab, Dave says. Yeah, I didn't do a money grab yet. Oh, I did do a money grab at the beginning, didn't I?
Yeah.
The DIY course.
But then we talked about giving one free that we're charging Michael. So it's balanced.
Yeah, we balance it out. Ben, my HD keeps telling me there is no such thing as a private event, but still have not shown me this in the codes. They say if I'm serving people, it is public. Doesn't matter where I'm at. That's bull crap. Right. David, what state are you in? You can private message me or email me if you want, and I'll give you the link to your state codes. Yeah. and that trumps anything your county's telling you, unless you're in California. California does it by county. Even though they have state codes, the counties go, you know what? We're going to make this even worse. And each county does their own thing. But you, I'll show you. No, the health department's wrong. Go to learnhotdogs.com/liar. I know I've given a lot of links, but learnhotdogs.com/liar. It's a nice way of getting the information out of them and vetting what this supposed smart person in authority is telling you.
Only if you're charging the public in a public location. That's the only time you're bending. Otherwise, catering, it's a private event.
Frankenstein's nailed it. I work for my money. The money is good. There's a vendor y'all should be following. If you follow vendors, follow Love Food Truck, follow Old Doggies. There's a bunch of them to follow. But
the Frankenstein's, he just got his lemonade squisher, smasher, smusher.
Thingamabobber. Yeah, yep. Thingamajigger.
This could be a long web link for Warren when he changes it to that.
Yeah, that'd be crazy. Frankenstein's, y'all need to be following either way. He's not in a huge city. He's in the mountains in Western North Carolina, right across from me, and literally over the mountain from me. And he's a good vendor that you should be following, looking at what he's doing, picking up tips and ideas. And if you did that with Robbie Miller and Tammy, you know, at Crazy Dogs, you do that with Jason, you do that with Corey, there's a blue million of them you can do it with. You're going to learn things. You're going to pick up things and you're going to get better and you're going to spend less time vending and still make more money.
Well, that also goes hand in hand with getting on to Vendors United and, you know, networking with other vendors and seeing how things are. I mean, Frankenstein, I guess, saw guys with lemonade. That was his next step, you know, and boom, there he goes.
This is one I haven't heard in a long time. It's a good question. Mark, there's 208 first world nations in the world. Okay. We statistically have the worst healthcare. Statistically. We kill more people with drugs than any other country in the 208 first world nations. We also don't care about health insurance for everybody kind of deal. It's kind of like a right. I think it is a right. I may be wrong. I may piss off half of you. I think it's a right. It's kind of like if I know Jason needs food, I don't care if the government takes some of my tax money to feed him. I was on food stamps. Thank God for food stamps. I'm glad food stamps exist. Yes, is it socialism? Yes, it is socialism. It's everybody pitching in taxes so that I could feed my kids. But I needed it at the time.
Yep.
Healthcare, I believe that it's, I think first we should take care of our military because we don't even take care of their healthcare, not correctly. You know, when they're dying before they can even get an appointment at the VA, there's a problem. I'm not going to go on a rant there. Bottom line is health insurance. The best thing I've heard of is the National Association of Self-Employed. And there's another one the other day somebody brought up. Jason, what was it?
I can't think what that is. But you can also check in with your local Chamber of Commerce because a lot of times they put a couple smaller businesses together to create
a group policy.
Business group under an umbrella of one policy. So Ben might only have one employee and I've got three. You put us together with two others and now we've got whatever they need and it drops the rate. So, you know, I would check with your local, you know, business groups because that's usually a good way to go. Also, SCORE can help with that too in your local area. Service Corps of Retired Executives, check them out.
Yeah. SCORE is a good one. We have this on the blog already at learnhotdogs.com.
Yeah, the worst case scenario, Ben, Aflac. I mean, you know.
Well, Aflac is great for like an emergency, you know, you got injured. And I provided, back when I had the furniture stores, I provided Aflac for all the employees because it made good sense if they you know, they got a hangnail or they broke a foot. It covered them. It even paid their salary while they were away from work.
And basically the easiest way to figure your Aflac a broad generalization is whatever your week is divided by your paycheck, it's 1 hour is what you're going to pay roughly to cover your salary.
Right.
So, you know, a nice benefit for the self-employed. It is a good thing to have if you do it.
John, Bigfoot Hot Dogs in the house, catering high school kids, love it. Jose Pino says, what's the best refrigerator for a cart? Need one for California. Here's what I'm going to tell you, Alexander. California is tricky. I've got over 200 customers there who have fridges on their cart and they use our fridge, which is just a, I can't think of it. Echo Star.
Yep. The AC/DC unit.
AC/DC unit. Yeah. But there is another company that makes one similar. It's about four times as much. Same space, same cooling capacity, same amperage, same everything, but it's NSF. And some counties in California require it to be NSF or UL or ETL or ANSI of some sort. I would check into that. Make sure it's in your county codes that it says it has to be one of those, you know, tested things. Otherwise, I'd go with the standard one because it's much
cheaper. It's going to need a generator. You know, the one Ben's talking about will run on DC.
Which means it'll run on a battery, like a marine battery.
So I would check that out. Also, I guess it's also going to depend on what's the space on the cart or truck or trailer. You know what I mean?
So I hope that helps you. If you have any problem finding one, send me an email at ben@vendorsunited.com and I will, I'll send you the link to the one that I know that is approved statewide in California. And then I'll send you a link to the one we use directly in case you already have a cart and you just want to add it. You can buy them direct from the manufacturer for about, $450.
Nice. Brian Shores used one of those for his ice cream. Remember?
We've been using them for years and we've got them in California approved, but California is tricky.
Yeah.
Let's see. Did Keith send the, okay. I don't know that we got time for all this. James says, thanks for sending. That's Jimmy. Jimmy, you know, I got a dad vet, grandpa vet, daughter vet, son-in-law vet. Absolutely. Thank you for your service and thank everybody for their service that makes it.
If I'm out, you know, vets come up to my truck, they eat on me, man. That's, you know, like I said, I showed you guys before, POW bracelet, 47, it's been on there 46 years. You know, they're not forgotten, at least not while, you know, guys like us are sitting around and, you know, thanking you and remembering you. So, you know, thank you for your service and, you know, other vendors, I hope you guys do the same thing, especially active duty guys, man. I never, ever take money from active duty.
Now, if you work at a military base,
that's a different story.
Different deal. Right.
Corey's got a cart over there at that Fort Hood or wherever he's at.
Fort Leonard Wood.
Yeah, he'd be in a world.
Yeah, you'd have to have a bigger Brinks truck or Wells Fargo truck, one that's bringing you money each day.
Money in reverse, yeah.
Right. I appreciate y'all all. I'm glad you were here. And, Bab says pan liners. Is she answering somebody's question or?
I'm not sure.
Or is she just like got Tourette's and she's going, pan liners?
She's vendor Tourette's.
Yeah, vendor Tourette's. Pan liners. Pan liners, we've got them on our site, but the company that we get them from, and you can buy them directly from them. In fact, if you'll call them and say, hey, send me a sample, they'll send you a free sample. Just say, hey, Ben told me I could get a free sample. They'll send you a sample of everything they make. They're good people, and it's called pansaver.com, pansaver.com. Holler at them, go, Ben said, I was on the show, Ben and Jason said, that you'd send me free pan liners, they will. I'm telling you. Thank you, Jose. Appreciate it, brother. Love you. Babs, she said, yep, but she didn't tell me yep about what. We said like three different options for her. Babs is in the bourbon. Thank you, Robbie. Thanks for posting in the Vendors United group. I begged Robbie and Tammy to join Vendors United for 2 months, and they finally joined, and everybody loves them because they post up videos, they share stuff. I love it. They're great vendors. That's another one you got to watch because they're going to go boo. So y'all have a good one, and I appreciate it. Enjoyed it a bunch.
See you, Ben. Have a good night, guys.
See you.